Hi, this is Luca, Majno. We're back with TLBTV's Learn to Unlearn with our special guest, Gregory Ford, once a week. And we're happy to say that we're both co-hosts, and this is not my show. This is a show, a platform for Greg to be able to talk about what's going on. And there's a lot of events going on with the new Paris attack just today, not even hours old. And I'll give the floor right to you, Greg.
Oh, okay. That was fast. Mm. Okay. All right. You bet. Hey, we have got a lot of things to cover, a lot of ground to cover, and I hope your listeners are going to be up for it. Okay. First of all, okay. Hey, if I can say anything about these shows, I can say this, okay? This should be our motto. Truth is warning, okay? And these times, we need warning about when these things are going to happen, okay? Because we can't count on our own agencies to warn us of terrorist attacks, because surprise, most of our agencies are behind these terrorist attacks. Okay, I hope that's clear. And I'm going to read something from a great book that probably won't be out there very long. It's called The CIA as Organized Crime by Doug Valentine. Okay, all of your listeners should run out and buy it, because the CIA is scrambling to get it wiped off the shelves as fast as they can. Okay, and I'm going to read you something that relates directly to my court case. Okay, so later on in the show, I want everybody to be listening to this. Okay, but as I said, the truth is warning. Okay, we had an attack in London, and I warned, okay, on your show, I warned that there would be an attack in London. This was just opposite, adjacent to the Manchester attacks, okay? Funny thing about all that, the Manchester attacks, is Manchester is basically the headquarters of a group called Conflict Solution. Everybody should go look up Conflict Solution. On the face of it, they portray themselves as a hostage rescue group that goes all over the world rescuing people that are caught in trouble. Sounds noble, okay? Yes, and it's what they do. At least a division of Conflict Solutions does that. And they're very good at what they do. And they have some fine people, okay? Well, the CIA started out that way too, okay? The Cocaine Importation Agency, remember them, okay? No, it's not the Culinary Institute of America. No, it is actually, in every sense of the word, the Cocaine Importation Agency, the CIA, okay? Same thing. What we have here now is, yes, the headquarters for this group, Conflict Solution, in England, is just outside of Manchester. Where has that happened in the news recently? Manchester. Okay, and not surprising, I said on your show the next attack would be in England still. That's the pattern of these things. There is definitely an established pattern. England, okay? UK, specifically, all right? And sure enough, there it is in London at a very specific site, okay? Very specific location. Gee, imagine that. Where have we heard of cars being commandeered and driving people, running people over the road, off the road, being on a bridge where they don't really have anywhere to go, leaping into the, in this case, the Thames, and then there was the Seine River in Paris. Oh, Paris. Gee, a new attack in Paris. What is this about all these terrorist attacks? Paris is no stranger to attacks. I was in Paris. I was at Notre Dame no more than 10 months ago, okay? I know that they have security. I know that they are fighting a terrorist war, okay, on their grounds. But who would be smarter and sharper and tougher to pull off a bizarre terrorist attack like they just had at Notre Dame than a directed terrorist attack by Conflict Solutions? And I'll send a message to Conflict Solutions right now. Especially to their, even though they are a through and through British operation, okay, to their two Israeli descendants, okay, I'll tell you what, and you can broadcast this on your entire network. Not on my watch. They're not going to pull this. Not on my watch. All right? So there are two Israeli descendants that work for Conflict Solutions. No, there, you know, people are onto them. Yes, they have this, yeah, this capability. And by the way, you best check your CIA connections too. Those seem to be pretty loose right now. All right. So with that in mind, the Paris attacks, okay. Some guy with a hammer, okay, attacks the police. Shot dead. Okay. No, wait, he's not shot dead. He's still alive. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I want to hear what he has to say. Okay. And there is going to be, as of this morning, from my sources, escalation of chaos. This chaos is going to happen. Now, when I say chaos, this is onward, is that, hey, these folks, all these, quote, Muslims, they're always bad old Muslims, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm going to give you a reason why these people are as angry as they are, okay? It's just a situation, okay? They are receiving orders now to fight back any way they can, okay? Any way they can. You'd be surprised what is available to somebody that doesn't have a gun in a city, a packed city full of people. Do you have a driver's license, little boy? Yes. Okay, guess what? You have a 2.5-ton, you know, rotating armored piece of equipment that can mow down hundreds of people before you're stopped, okay? And how many of those running around the streets of these major metropolitan centers? Hundreds, thousands available, okay, like the Scandia truck, okay, in Berlin, all right? Gee, how tough was that to get a hold of a, what, 15-ton vehicle? And mow down hundreds of people, okay? France, same thing. It doesn't take much. And then if you just want to, you know, have a little personal exchange here, you just pull out a good old steak knife and walk into a restaurant like what happened in London, okay? They walked into a restaurant and knifed whoever was closest, okay? You can't stop it. And this all is emanating from what has happened in Iraq, okay? In Iraq, all right? And I'm going to give you a little bit of background because the U.S. Supreme Court is now dealing with what I have told the Supreme Court and my court case, all right? Why this is happening, why this terrorism is so specific and pointed and never-ending. You want to see a never-ending war? Just watch this warrant of terrorism, okay? Guess who brought it on, okay? The CIA, the Mossad, okay? And if you doubt my words, hey, I will read you something. It won't be my words, I'll read you something. Okay, uh-oh, something's happening in the United States. What is this about this last election? What a bunch, Yeah, Luca, you're free to step in at any time and try to make me believe something here about America. Are we that far gone? Are the American people that stupid? Have they been caught up? Have they been caught up in this leave no idiot behind program by the education program by George Bush, where they believe this crap that they hear on the news? Okay, I think so. All right. Let's see. Where do we need to start? First of all, Seth Rich. Okay, that comes to mind. Seth Rich. I just found out Seth Rich, after he was shot, okay, at 3 o'clock in the morning, he was taken into a hospital and the doctors had him stabilized. Okay, 22 law enforcement people walk into the room, of course. Now, what is a doctor doing allowing 22 law enforcement people to walk into a room, okay? Well, it appears that one of those law enforcement people, and I almost narrowed it down to which one that was, okay, they proceeded to shoot him with a toxic compound, inject him full of a toxic compound, okay? Yes, he was stabilized, he was gonna make it, and after they left, uh-oh, we have a dead body on our hands. Seth Rich, Mr. Seth Rich. And also, some of the, you know, and here's what was going on really, okay? There's a lot of obfuscation, a lot of inveigling, a lot of prevarication going on, okay, to quote the X-Files. All right, uh-oh, what is this now about, what is her name? Huma Wiener, okay? I'm never sure if they're actually together anymore or if they're divorced or what, okay? You call her Huma Abedin. Oh, I was notified this morning that she is a triple agent. Okay, a triple intelligence agent. There's only one person besides me, you, Luca, and everyone listening to this show that knows that. Okay, she is a triple agent, has been working with Pakistani ISI. Uh-oh, big problem there. Pakistani ISI, as in that the Pakistan that, let me see. What is it? They provide 98% of the world's heroin, opiates. Okay. Gee, on the cover of New York Times today, it's the highest it's ever been and climbing. Poisoning, death by opiates, opium derivatives. All right.
I saw that.
Guess what? Okay. It's all coming through Pakistan. And I hate to sound cynical. I hate to sound caustic. I hate to sound disillusioned, but when I went with me, with my limited resources, I look back and say, now who in the intelligence field, okay, as in Pakistani ISI, as in CIA, okay, and you can confirm all this with Huma Abedin if you want, all right, who would know, okay, about selling drugs to the American people, okay, who would know more than George H.W. Bush and the Bush crime family. Who would know more? Period. Okay? Because they've been involved in it all their lives, selling drugs. Okay? Infiltrating the Drug Enforcement Agency. Guess who? It's the Bush family. Okay? Why isn't Poppy Bush making license plates in Leavenworth? They can put him in a wheelchair. They have a disabled section. You know, Leavenworth Prison, it doesn't discriminate against disabled people. Hey, stick him in there. Instead of letting him do a parachute drop every time he has a birthday, hey, drop him into Leavenworth, all right? And we'll take care of the paperwork later, okay? Think of how many people he's been responsible for killing, torturing, brutalizing, all the tons and tons of drugs brought into the United States, the destruction of, you know, intentional destruction of minorities, they've been targeted. It's George H.W. Bush. But guess who, until I just told you this, knew about all of this behavior? The other intelligence operative, Hillary Rodham Clinton. Okay? Hillary Rodham Clinton is directly responsible for all the issues that have been happening recently, and from all sources, okay, yes, this has been an active spy, ISI spy ring, ISI slash CIA, okay, Huma's door, okay, on one of her properties, or Huma Wiener, okay, had her door kicked in, okay, by the FBI. You know, this flaky nutcase, okay, proceeded to leave all her spy equipment, computers, laptops, and Blackberries. Uh-oh, there it is. There's the buzzword here, Blackberries. It appears now that Mr. Obama loves his Blackberries and had everyone in Washington that worked for him issued a Blackberry. Well, ISI folks, ISI Pakistan, has been collecting information all through the Obama administration on, okay, from those Blackberries, okay? Yes, the CIA has accommodated the spying on our government, our own diplomats, our own people, administrators and so forth, from those Blackberries. And most of the information was being sent through those computers, okay? On Huma Huma Wiener's property. Okay. How'd that happen? Well, it turns out that, of course, being a flaky politician, she decided to maximize her returns. Okay. Excuse me, politician / triple agent. And she rented the property without getting her computer equipment out of there. Okay. Mm-hmm. A U.S. Marine rented the property, found the equipment, called the FBI. Okay. And surprise, it was confirmed in the 43,000 emails going back and forth from Hillary Clinton. Okay. To all her sources. That's what is in the information that Mr. Comey is going to be speaking about. If he doesn't give a weak sister, limp-wristed, watered-down, namby-pamby, cowardly version of events, that's what he is going to say. What is it, Wednesday, Thursday, something like that? That's what we have going on, okay? We have a triple agent, Huma Wiener, working in conjunction with Hillary Clinton. And why isn't Hillary Clinton at the women's facility down in Frontera, California, the federal pen for female criminals? Yes, she is. Okay. Yes, she is a criminal. That's all there is to it. And she's been working with who else could she be working with but Huma Wiener? Okay, you know the Mata Hari. Okay, we'll call her the Mata Hari of Washington. You know, and let's face it, poor old Anthony, screwed up Anthony, okay, you know, what is he, Carlos Danger? That's his radio handle, Carlos Danger, okay. Can't keep his pants up, remember him? Okay, well, you know, it appears now that there's been a little cooperation, okay. Why do these people that lead these nefarious lives have to go into spying and espionage? I don't know. I've been a counterintelligence, you know, operational person for what, 30 years, three decades now? Okay. I don't understand it. I'm just a simple guy. I don't understand it. Maybe one of our viewers could call in and tell us why these idiots go into politics, okay, when they're spies, spying on the United States of America. Why do they do this? Okay. So yeah, no, we've got all kinds of other stuff going on too. Okay. Hey, I'm waiting for one of my sources right now to call in about the Russian issue. Okay. It appears that the head of the State Department of Russia, okay, is going to call in and give us a download on what Mr. Obama was doing. Remember the Manchurian candidate? Nobody even managed to get a social security on Mr. Obama. And funny how that managed to stay in place for 8 years. Okay. Well, I think the Russians are going to tell us, okay, what he was doing. All right. That's in the works. It's going to happen very shortly, possibly today, possibly tomorrow or Wednesday. Okay. What's tomorrow? Wednesday. Yes. Thursday. Okay. Now, word is, okay, and my source is going to back all this Russian business up, okay? I've got a lot of things that the Russians are preparing to release, and my associate and good friend is going to tell me, given the fact that he was responsible and helped me on the Phil Marshall issue, the Phil Marshall assassination, okay? Yes, he was helping me on that issue, and he's also helped me find the fifth manuscript that Phil Marshall did concerning who did what, who paid who on 9/11 attacks, how the money was transferred. I think the folks at Boeing, as in Boeing, okay, Boeing have a lot of questions to answer about hiring Arabic speakers and linguists to train the 19 hijackers, okay, and why the 19 hijackers were so super efficient at flying the 757, the 757, okay, as in North and South Tower strikes,
mm-hmm.
okay, and also figure out who was flying that the Air Force One 747 that was circling Washington while these attacks were happening and taking place. Little clue, they were marked as Air Force One, okay? The plane was Air Force One, all right? So the Boeing people have a lot to answer for, okay? All right? As I can state that, yes, this training was going on when I was just a few miles away myself, all right? And they were being trained in Pinal Airport. So that, yes, that all is coming out. Okay, we're gonna have that very shortly. Okay.
Well, you might not find a court high enough placed to even, you know, prosecute these people, because isn't it the government that tells the court what to do?
Oh, yes. According to our Supreme Court, they don't make a decision unless they get an order from the government.
There you go. So they're immune from prosecution, these buggers. They can do whatever they want.
Oh yeah, pretty much. So now we're just in time, by the way. I'm going to read your listeners what is the basis of my court case and why they're trying to figure out what to do with my court case now. Basically trying to figure out how to get out of it gracefully, mm-hmm. okay? Okay. Let me see. All right. See the book? All right. Everybody can see that?
Yeah, okay. The problem is that we can't hear you very good because we're being jammed right now. I lost a little bit of your video earlier, but I'm able to fix it. But okay. I'm hoping we can keep it up.
Well, one of the things that Doug Valentine, this man right here, Doug Valentine, informed me of is that, hey, if the agency feels any threat, even for a nanosecond, all right, they will start jamming signals, okay? Mm-hmm. Gee, where have we heard this before? Jamming signals. And what is this about the agency spying on every aspect of U.S. civilian life? Aren't there something called laws, okay? Nope. I'm mystified. Okay. I mean, didn't Ed Snowden tell us that they were doing illegal action? Ed Snowden, okay, who Donald Trump calls a traitor and should be executed mm-hmm. for treason. Well, funny, Mr. Speaking of Donald Trump, okay, I know he means well. You know, and as a member of an organized international syndicate, crime syndicate, the Russian-Israeli syndicate, okay, he would probably, you know, take exception to having anybody threaten his position, which is happening now. But I'm going to read. How's the audio on this, Luca?
Doing good.
Okay.
Hurry up.
Okay. War crimes policy. Okay, by Doug Valentine. Okay. In February 2013, The Guardian and the BBC Arabic unveiled a documentary film exploring the role of retired Colonel James Steele in the recruitment and training and initial deployments of the CIA advised funded special police commandos in Iraq. Okay. Gee, imagine where they were doing all this bad stuff. Okay. And James Steele, by the way, all right, was in Central America with me. And to show you what a kinder, gentler man James Steele is, he was known, it's to this day, as the butcher of Latin America. Why would they send a professional colonel, okay, to El Salvador in this case? Why would they call him the butcher of Latin America? All right. I'll tell you, okay. The documentary was a departure from mainstream reporting in that it told how the commandos tortured and murdered tens of thousands of Iraqi men and boys. But the commandos are only one of America's many weapons of human destruction in Iraq, along with U.S. military forces that murder indiscriminately, CIA-funded death squads that murdered selectively, and the CIA's Palace Guard, the Iraqi Special Operations Forces. The commandos are part of a genocidal campaign that killed 10% of the Sunni Arabs of Iraq by 2008 and driven half of all Sunnis from their homes, including economic sanctions and a 50-year history of sabotage and subversion. America and its Iraqi collaborators have visited far more death and destruction on Iraq than Saddam Hussein and his Baathist regime, okay, which, by the way, was headquartered in Samarra, Iraq, where I was stationed, okay, and driven into fanaticism by the brutal invasion and occupation. Many thousands of Sunnis then formed the Islamic State of Iraq, ISI, okay? Mm-hmm. After being decimated by U.S. forces, ISI was reinforced by Baathist military and intelligence officers, as well as foreign mercenaries from places like Chechnya, okay? Now known as ISIS, the militant Sunni resistance seized vast stretches of land in Iraq and Syria. Only as recently as June 2016 was it finally driven out of Fallujah. In the weeks after the documentary, American pundits began cataloging the horrors that piled up by 2013. They told how the Bush and Obama regimes killed more than 1 million Iraqis, displaced 5 million, and imprisoned and tortured hundreds of thousands without trial. The photos that were released of brutality at Abu Ghraib prison, and everyone knows Abu Ghraib prison, okay, give an inkling of the terror of which the Iraqis were subjected. The draconian administration detention laws, systematic torture, and executions that characterize the occupation are still in place in 2016. Mm-hmm. The prime minister's office, a position now held by Hadar al-Jawad al-Abad, is where the CIA-managed counterterrorism service is still ensconced. Oh, we got out of Iraq all right. It certainly sounds like it. Okay, in May 2016, the CTS gained fame for leading the U.S. offensive to take back from Fallujah from ISIS that had occupied the city since 2014. By the way, you know, if the listeners haven't heard in the last 24 hours, the U.S. government has now been caught giving $1 billion of new weapons, medium weapons, and munitions to go with it to ISIS. Uh-oh, okay. So let me see, where are we at now? Okay, in May 2016, okay, Iraqi soldiers and national police assisted forces in the systematic oppression of the Americans imposed, that Americans imposed on Iraq to meet the definition of genocide and the genocide conventions. Okay, genocide in the Geneva Conventions, guaranteeing protection to civilians in time of war. By the way, that last passage is in my court case to the U.S. Supreme Court. But the guilty Americans have gone unpunished for their war crimes. Oh boy, big surprise, okay? Not the least of which was falsifying. Can everybody hear out there, Luca? All right, I want everybody to listen to this. Falsifying intelligence about Iraq's non-existent weapons of mass destruction, okay? Please, I hope everybody heard that, because you know where you heard the truth. Right here, British legal advisors repeatedly warned their government in 2003 that invading Iraq would be a, quote, crime of aggression, okay? That wording right there is exactly what I sent to the Supreme Court. Crime of aggression. All right, premeditated aggression, which they called one of the most serious offenses under international law, okay? For anyone familiar with the CIA, the systematic oppression was predictable, but the U.S. government, as usual, destroyed and conceals most of the hard evidence of its war crimes, making it harder to prove, and the media is content to revise history and focus public attention on front men like James Steele, rather than the institutions, particularly the CIA. for whom they work. Okay, so that's enough, all right? Everything that you just heard, I have submitted to the Supreme Court, okay? And if you're saying, well, what does this guy know about the CIA? Surprise, folks, William Colby actually authorized this man to do the investigations of the CIA. He probably had no idea, in any sense of the word, that this book was going to come out. Okay, he would be turning in his grave. Turning in his grave. What happened to William Colby, the head of the CIA? Well, he met a very mysterious death. Okay, all right. He was canoeing, and somebody turned his canoe over and held him underwater till he drowned. Okay. And this organization is supposed to be protecting America? Okay, I hope nobody is sleeping better in their beds tonight, okay, knowing that the CIA is protecting you. If this is what they call protection, what do they call extortion, murder, and political assassination, all right? No, in every essence, folks, there's only one way to deal with this, and that is to bring back Stansfield Turner, okay, and dismantle the CIA in its present form. Everybody says, well, that'll start terrorism right back up again. Guess what, folks? CIA is terrorism, all right? What part about that don't you understand? They understand it in London. They understand it in France, okay? What part about that don't you understand, all right? After the Soviet Union fell apart, they needed a new money-making scheme, okay? All right, just ask the Bush family. Hey, the Bush family's brought in virtually all cocaine, opium derivatives, and heroin into this country, okay? They just can't figure out how to get their hooks into methamphetamine production. But it's the Bush family. Guess who started the CIA? The Bush family. Am I the only one that thinks at all and remembers anything in this country? I'm beginning to think I am, okay? It was the Bush family, Prescott Bush and Avril Harriman, put together a Rothschild-like intelligence agency to help the oligarchs, okay? Mm-hmm. The oligarchs of this country. And don't think for one second the CIA is out there fighting the good fight for freedom and terrorism. No, their prime directive is to go into these countries like they did in Central America and kill any other people that are asking for reforms, okay? Like, as in, get some of the land that they've been working, forced to work, okay? And protecting the plutocracy of those countries entirely and fighting anything that resembles reform, all right? That's what the CIA has been doing, telling you, oh yeah, these bad old death squads, they're out there, the CIA's fighting terrorism. Oh really? Okay, gosh. If we're able to make this recording without having interference from the agency, it would be miraculous. But that's why we've got to get this out there, all right? To at least the educated listeners, okay, of the show.
Mm-hmm. I think one word for the CIA would be destabilization. Destabilization agent. I think that's a good term for the CIA. They're there to destabilize everything on Earth.
Oh, yes. Hey, destabilization creates the fear of instability, okay? I mean, I just read you how the Iraqis sleep at night. They don't sleep at night, okay? In Central America, they never slept. For years, they never slept because of the CIA. The CIA in Syria. The CIA in Yemen, okay? What part about that don't people understand? And now we've got, okay, and how does this really relate? Because it's all overseas, it's foreign, it's distant in the distant nowhere lands, okay? Well, guess what? We've got this happening where people that are doing the right things, whistleblowers, are being murdered after they've been shot down on the streets and they're barely alive. They've been murdered by these people, okay? Yes, Seth Rich was murdered. What part about that don't you understand? Oh, well, he was shot. No, he was poisoned, okay? One of the, quote, law enforcement people that went into his room poisoned him, all right? Just that simple. And yes, yeah, all those emails, guess what? They substantiate the entire monitoring process of our political body for about the last, what, 10, 12 years now? Okay. Everything we've done has gone to the ISI, and which goes to the agency. Okay. In return, Pakistanis are allowed to ship in 98 to 100% of all heroin into this country. Oh, gosh. You think cocaine has slowed down? Cocaine in coming into this country has slowed down at all? No, afraid not, folks. If you want to see the truth, read this book. Read this book, okay? Real simple, read this book, because that information came from the agency. It came from the agency, all right? Yes, Afghanistan is disintegrating intentionally, okay? Mm-hmm. All those opium fields, okay, that, oh, Blackwater is protecting, Blackwater, the mercenary group, is protecting. Oh, gosh, I did some checking, all right, for your listeners, found out, hey, the Blackwater did not at any time ever work for Department of Defense, where they could be maybe subjected to annihilating women and kids. Oh, no, no. Nope. Here's something I want everybody to understand, and this will paint a really rosy picture on everything. Okay? We all know, you know, who the snake goddess is. Okay? Hillary Rodham Clinton. Okay? Guess what? She's been agency herself long before. Even back when she was going after Richard Nixon, that's when she became an agent. Yes, she's been directing that idiot, Wild Bill, the wild man, okay, all right? But the thing is she had wanted to get her hands on a private mercenary group. Okay, guess who that mercenary group is? Blackwater. Blackwater can't operate under Department of Defense laws and rules. Not that they're all that stringent, mind you. Okay, they operated under Hillary Clinton and as the Secretary of State. They work for the State Department. Mm-hmm. So they've got their own mercenary group running around killing people ad hoc and at will, at the courtesy of the agency. Thank God we dodged that bullet. We're not out of the woods yet, but Hillary Clinton, okay, yes, is a CIA operative. And yes, she gives her orders to Huma Abedin, a triple agent, all right? You know, what more do you need to say about these new hearings coming up, okay? And by the way, if James Comey is a little bit honest, he will talk about yours truly, me, all right? Frank Gregory Ford. Guess who gave him all the information 2 months after he was sworn into his office? Okay, James Comey received every night for 3 weeks a new report on the debriefing of the torture going on in Iraq and the weapons of mass destruction that were present in Iraq. Okay, guess what? He had those reports on his desk. And yes, they haven't forgotten, folks. Okay, they have not forgotten. Now, he's being portrayed as a somewhat protector of Hillary Clinton. No, that's not who's telling him what to do. Okay. How do you spell cocaine importation agency of America? All right, that should tell you exactly what's going on here. Okay. So, you know, I think that should give your listeners, everybody that listens to this show, okay, a little to think about. Hey, an educated listener is a valuable listener, and a valuable listener is a viable listener. And a viable listener is a doer, not just a sit around on your thumbs and rotate on in your hands, okay, type of listener. I need listeners that are out there challenging every single aspect of what we are being told right now, all right? And yes, by the way, don't think for a second that the powers that be aren't listening to this show and thinking, oh, we just need to change access to controlling the internet, okay? If the internet goes down, folks, all right, Luca, guess what? It's the agency behind it. They don't like what somebody's saying, i.e. me, about the agency, okay?
Right.
Yes. Yep. It's getting very tenuous, the control over the internet.
Isn't that what Elizabeth May said? After the London attacks, we have to have regulation on the internet. Of course.
Yeah. And who said that? Oh, surprise. The fellow who is the lapdog for the Israelis, okay, as Mr. AIPAC, Joe Lieberman, all right? Remember him? Whiny Joe, all right? We've got to be able to shut down the internet when somebody says something we don't like. Joe Lieberman, okay? The same group of four, the gang of four, we'll call them, okay? Thanks to Chairman Mao, we'll call them the gang of four, okay? Hillary Rodham Clinton, Joe Lieberman, John McCain, and that big, whiny, wimpy pussy, what is his name? Lindsey Graham, okay? Lindsey Graham, all right? Okay, you know, he was, by the way, he was the one who said, my boss, okay, General Janice Karpinski from Iraq, who I try to get my intelligence reports to, okay, he came on when he found out that I had been trying to get my reports to her. He was the one who came on and said, oh, we need to court-martial her, okay? He tried to have General Janice Karpinski court-martialed, okay? Yes, Lindsey Graham, all right? Gee, now, what is there to say about this group, okay? And the first thing I would say is, want to find out who got $1 billion of weapons to ISIS? Want to find out who's been supporting ISIS and sending in retired American generals to run ISIS and Israeli generals to run ISIS? Okay. Why don't we just ask this group? Okay. And funny thing, I just heard this morning, okay, that, oh, we don't have the same nuclear capability that we had in terms of producing weapons. Uh-oh, how'd that happen? It's because I said this on your show before, okay, Hillary Rodham Clinton sold 20% of our nuclear radioactive isotopes, okay, used in weapon production, okay, to Mad Vlad himself, Vladimir Putin. Hey, folks, what does that tell you? When Hillary Clinton, who takes a commission on the sale of this stuff, okay, like her miserable, lying, thieving, son of a bitch husband who sold the missile telemetry research, which the American people paid for, okay, he sells it to the Chinese, the Chinese, who are the main supporters of North Korea. He's you know, they have the telemetry now to develop. If they haven't already, they don't seem to be hesitating at much these days. North Koreans have the telemetry to send a missile right into the laps of the heartland of America, all right? First place they ought to send one is to Little Rock, Arkansas, home of the Rose Law Firm and Hillary and the Clintons, okay? Hillary Clinton at the Rose Law Firm, all right? That's where they ought to send the first one, okay? But yes, guess what? You think the North Koreans don't have the capability of developing a missile? They've already developed it, you idiots out there. Listen, you know, 18 months ago, a missile was seen streaking through the skies of Southern California and lands 18 and a half miles offshore. Oh, and of course, immediately the government said, oh, that was just an atmospheric anomaly. Oh boy, yeah, they're saying that in Japan nowadays, okay? A lot of atmospheric anomalies going over Japan, okay? And the Sea of Japan, all right? As in ICBM, multiple reentry vehicle, okay, headed your way, all right? That one came from a submarine, a North Korean submarine, okay? It was probably the same sub that fired the torpedo that destroyed that South Korean destroyer, okay? Right off the shore there, South Korea. Yeah, how many South Korean sailors did that kill? Well, that torpedo, it blew that ship to hell and back, all right? Yes, uh-oh, surprise, the North Koreans have submarines, okay? North Koreans have submarines. Now, funny is, what was it, last week, our elected Russian-Israeli representative, okay, to the presidency of the United States, okay, notified, who was it? He notified the Russians that we now have submarines in position off the shore of North Korea. Who are these people that are running this country? Who are they? You know, I am a brain damaged operative. Thanks to my service to America, I now have suffer brain damage. As a result, I can figure this out. Okay, I can put it together. All right, but somehow no one saw fit to elect me. Who, by the way, I was a candidate for the presidency of the United States last time. Okay, under the Bull Moose Party platform. Okay, who can say anything wrong about the Bull Moose Party? Okay, but you can find plenty wrong with, you know, those wonderful about turn, two-faced, backstabbing Democrats. Okay, there's plenty. Hey, you know, the most dangerous thing I've ever seen is when you go to work for the Democratic Party on a campaign. You know, there's a good chance that you're going to catch a bullet in the back of the head, or excuse me, as they like to say in Arkansas. Okay, when you get your head cut off, decapitated, severed, sitting in your car, okay, in an intersection, and they refer to that as death by natural causes. Okay. And by the way, that person that had that happen was about to testify against the Clintons, okay, on the cocaine issue in Mena, Arkansas. Okay, Mena Airport, Arkansas. Okay. The sole supporter of, what is it, 10% of the cocaine imports into this country, as paid by the Bush family, okay, and the CIA, of course, okay. Any questions about that, just ask Gary Webb. Oh, I'm sorry, Gary Webb was killed too when he wrote the story on the CIA smuggling cocaine in. Gary Webb was killed by his family's old single-action revolver. In other words, folks, he pulled the hammer back twice to shoot himself in the head, okay? What is it about, you know, if you say the right thing, do the right thing, follow the law, okay, like me, okay, follow the law to the letter, okay, this is in my court papers, by the way, you run a real danger of being shot, okay, dying of suicide, getting your head cut off on an intersection, and then having it referred to as natural causes, okay? You know, and everybody's probably wondering, well, how could all this, you know, all this bad crime go on, okay, say in Iraq, where they have, okay, inspector generals? Colonel Ted Vanderhoosing, okay? Colonel Ted Vanderhoosing. Name might not ring a bell much now. He was the inspector generals for war profiteering, checking on war profiteering in Iraq. He was the only one ever assigned to the position, okay? He notified his family he would be killed. He would not be coming home alive, all right? And surprise, less than 2 hours after he is back in Iraq, he mysteriously commits suicide. He was suicided, as they say in the trades,
right?
Okay? All right? Yeah, he was the only one who could tell the American people about paying double for Iraqi oil that was already refined and shipped to U.S. shores, okay? And did anyone, please tell me, Did anyone that's listening to this show ever see a price reduction in fuel at the pumps? Oh, of course not. No, because here's what happened, folks. All of that oil that was refined in Iraq, in southeast Iraq, that was shipped onto ships, okay, in the Persian Gulf, U.S. ships, and sent to the U.S. shores, how many drops, and I said drops, of that oil you think was offloaded when it hit American shores? Zero. Zero drops ever left those ships. And then it was, and then the American people, thanks to a high level of integrity group called the Halliburton Corporation. Okay. Oh, where have we heard that name before? And who's running that noble firm? Okay. Uh-oh, it was Dick Cheney. Okay. The fuel was then sent back, offloaded, and it was sent to 40 different military wars. I said wars and facilities in the Middle East regions, okay? Oh, that's okay, right? Oh, we're doing it for the war cause. Afraid not, people. Man, oh man. If you believe in America and the American government telling you the truth, I got news for you, okay? You might as well bend over and grab your ankles now, okay? Because guess what? They turned right around and gladly paid and gladly sold that fuel in the Persian Gulf back to the American government, okay, after the American government had already paid for it to be fraudulently shipped from Kuwait, fraudulently unloaded. It wasn't unloaded, by the way, sent back to the Persian Gulf, where it was sold to the American government at 2 to 3,000% per unit. Okay, you think you don't like paying a couple of bucks for a gallon of gas here, or 3 gallons of gas here, like we have in California, $3. Well, guess what? Try spending $200 to $300. $200 to $300 for a gallon of gas. That's what you were paying, folks. You are the American government. You are the war effort in Iraq. You were paying 2 to 3,000% markup on those units of fuel. You were, okay? I mean, not Dick Cheney, not Donald Rumsfeld, okay? Donald Rumsfeld was too busy torturing people at Abu Ghraib, okay? And he was too busy injecting the troops with his private companies, private corporations, vaccines, okay? You think I have a cough? Okay, occasionally I have to get up in the show, so I have to deal with my cough. Guess where that came from, Mr. Rumsfeld? Okay, so that's what we have, okay? And have we left Iraq? Oh, no, I just read you the fact that the counterterrorism service, as actually run by Americans, is there in Iraq. What, 15, 20, 50,000 people are still in Iraq, Americans? Still in Iraq. How many are in Syria now? Okay, Syria. I mean, in the invasion force there, getting ready to go in, just right across the border in Jordan. Okay, guess what? We've got another endless war happening. Okay, that's what I'm finding out. That's what I'm getting told about virtually every day. Okay, right?
Greg, I got to read you something. Does the name Willy Wimmer ring a bell?
Willy Say that Wimmer? Name again, please.
Willy Wimmer. It's called Wimmer in English, but it's Wimmer in German. Former State Secretary of the German Defense Ministry. Quote, "We should never forget who started the war in Syria. And when these human rights organizations blame one country in particular, we should never forget that the U.S., the Great Britain, France, Saudi Arabia, and Qatar created the civil war in Iraq." And he said, "I won't mention Israel because of the situation in the neighborhood," end quote.
Okay. I just heard this morning that because Qatar was so grievous, okay, you know, when our troops needed a break, guess where they went? They didn't go to the Riviera, French Riviera. They went to Qatar. As a result of that relationship, Now, five Arab countries are breaking off all relations with Qatar. Okay. So yes, I do agree with that estimate and analysis completely. All right. So in every sense of the word, Luca, how's your audio and how's your video? Okay, I'm sensing interference here.
Oh, it's been interference the whole hour, and we're right at the end of the hour too. We actually went over a little bit, but I just, in the few minutes left, because we're already past the hour, I just wanted to say thank you, Greg, for being on the show. And this is going to be a weekly show, so we can really, you know, kick butt and tell people what's going on with you know, upcoming events and even events that are happening now, to all the people that want to know what's going on. And I'm going to sign out. This is Luca Majno with Frank Gregory Ford, and I'm going to give you the last word. And this is the TLBTV project, Learn to Unlearn, and we'll be here every week.
Okay, well, as they say in the Arab world in Iraq, Maka Salama, Luca, and to your listeners, all right? Thank you so much
for having me on your show, as always. Thank you, Greg. There's so much to talk about, and there's so much appreciation to you from a lot more people than you think for what you've gone through and what you're going through all the time. And this whole PTSD BS that brings everything back in your plate from what you went through in Iraq and so much more. So we'll be talking to you again next week. And I got to thank you for being on the show.
Okay. Well, thank you. And I'll just, and a closing note, I hope everybody that listens to the show is the same person I am. That when I said we can't be committing these war crimes, all right, I was strapped to a stretcher, renditioned, tortured on the stretcher, all right, flown out, and then I was came to the U.S. with everybody running around saying, oh, no, we can't be doing that. Americans don't do that. Yes, Americans do that. Yes, people, your country is fast disappearing. Your control over it is fast disappearing. I mean, we don't have much more than a few weeks left of this country at the present level of constitutional rights and Bill of Rights and the privileges that we've always held dear. Those are fast disappearing, all right? So, hey, I can't wait to be on your show again. Okay, thank you so much, Luca.
You got it.
And thank you for your guests for listening to me. All right.
Thank you. We'll see you next week.
Have a good evening.